Welcome to the Sewing Connection, Series 10, Program 7. I'm Shirley Adams. Back in Series 5, we did some big hobo bags. In Series 9, we did bucket bags. And then many of you wrote to say you don't want all the contents of your purse in a jumble. You'd like to have sections in that bag to keep separate personal type things from business type things. This can be done with the greatest of ease from one simple measurement and a little extra lining fabric. Now, actually, all these bags you've seen in the past have had compartments, in a way. In the Series 8, we did some little bags like this. Now, what their lining looks like is this. They do have a little pocket in them, so that's something. You can put something separate in there to keep them a little separated. Those hobo bags that we did in Series 5 looked like this, with a curved top. And because of that, you can't have them too greatly compartmentalized. What I do have inside there, though, are a couple of big pockets. Here's one on one side, and on the other side, there's a big zipper pocket. So between these two pockets and the middle section, there actually are about three compartments. So in a way, that's compartmentalized. And let's take a closer look at how that actually goes. Now here's another one of those hobo bags. And basically, all of these bags are made in two sections. There is the inside section, the lining with its zipper, if it's going to zip. And then there's the outside section, and it has the shoulder strap on if it's going to have a strap. So two sections. All you need to do to finish them then is to put the lining section inside the other and stitch around the zipper is what happens. This zipper, by the way, was extra long. So once it's already stitched in and the zipper, therefore, the pull can't go beyond that stitching line that crosses it, then the rest of it could really just be cut off. There's no reason for it to be here. Don't cut it off until you stitch across it, or you've ruined your zipper, though. Okay, then what this has in it, remember, are those two sections. Here's one big pocket. Here's the other big zipper pocket. And so between all this, we are compartmentalized. But to put this inside the bag, it's going to just be all arranged inside here. It doesn't matter, really, which end is which end the zipper zips to or from. But notice how that zipper is zipped so that the pull of it, the tab here, is on the interfacing side. It's on the outside because what's going to happen is this will be all pinned in place here. Get it all equal so that everything's squared off. And then what's going to happen is that with that zipper open, I'll turn under the seam allowance on the bag out here, and I'm going to pin it to the zipper, and it's just going to be top stitched in place all around. So it's really a very simple process and one that everybody can do. So that's what will happen around here, and the bag's finished. But you still want compartments? Okay, let's do a different bag, and this is the hobo bag from Series 9. But just last program, I showed you how to do things with little bits and pieces. This was a combination of this pretty piece of painted leather and added to it on the top and on the sides in order to extend it and make it bigger were these extra pieces of man-made leather just to make it larger. Then you add such things as, a piping around the top and bottom to make it look more complete, to give it a more professional look. And then when this one opens, it has not the big pocket on each side, but it has actually different zippered compartments. Here are two of them on the outside, back and front. And then there is a zipper here, and this one also opens to a third compartment. So this one is really easy to make, and that's what we're going to do right now. Now, what this fabric is, actually it's leftovers from a blouse. Probably about a half yard or less of fabric is what it takes. But all of that fabric has then been stiffened considerably by being interfaced with some fusible interfacing. And this is what it looks like. Here's another bag of the same type. Now, I warn you, these things become addictive. You make one and you get ideas for more and more, and you just keep on going. And it's hard to stop making them. They really are fun and they really are easy. So you can see this one is also already to go. The strap is on it. And let me just tell you for a minute how I did this one a little differently. For one thing, what I have on here is twin needle top stitching. So here's the double needle, and you can see that's what puts all this together, makes little tucks there by using that. And of course you want to use a foot that has grooves in the bottom of it, because that grooved foot then allows the little tuck to come up as you do the stitching. And what I did first on this was just draw a pattern, draw a design, and I decided to do one diagonal stripe here and then do all these vertical lines here and the horizontal lines here. Actually, this was all in one big long piece, the whole bag, and there's only a seam on one end. The seam you can't see now, because on this one I made an extra long strap so it would go all the way from the bottom to cover up the seam and just continue around for the shoulder strap. So one side or the other of this did have a seam underneath, but it originally was just all one piece. So you get a lot of ideas like this as you go along and keep inventing, keep designing. It kind of frees your mind to do a lot more inventive things with sewing. So bags aren't a bad idea to make a few, just to get a little creative juice flowing there. But this is the lining that's going to go inside. And instead of being the very same size as the other bags that I showed you, instead of being a duplicate of the outside purse, this one is considerably bigger. Now the outside purse, this is the pattern from book 9 or series 9. The whole thing is only this big. This is what the bag actually looks like. This long, this high. What I have in this new lining now is not just that size, which would be, you know, half here and half there. It's not just that. It opens up a lot bigger, all this big. So I have a lot of fabric here. And I can see by the weave of the fabric that I use this lengthwise because it possibly is longer than what your fabric is wide. I noticed that I didn't have quite enough and I had to piece it here. That really doesn't make much difference. Who's going to look inside the lining of your bag and notice it? And so it really doesn't matter. You can piece it, it's fine. If you wanted to build some extra pockets in this, you could, and have a lot of compartments. But what I have done is measure this bag in order to get to where I am. I've measured the depth of it. Now naturally, what it measures from this to this edge is the same as what the width of the bag is. It's the very same because it's going to go in there sideways. But what all these other sections that open up measure, I want to know how deep this bag is, and if it's going to be, by the time the top edge is folded under, if it's going to be about 10 inches, then I want to make sure that I have about 10 inches here. And I don't have quite as much for the center section where it comes up, because I don't want one zipper to get tangled up in the other zipper. Therefore, I have this center section a little bit lower. I'll show you again in here how that center section comes down about an inch lower, just so that it won't interfere with the outside of the bag. You have to think ahead and do a little of these things in order to make it work right when you're finished. And so that center section is only about 9 inches deep. So I have a 9, a 9, a 9, and a 9. And then this outer one will be 10 again. So when it all accordion pleats up in place, and what I have done with this is, after I had it all measured and cut and pieced here, if you must, I have just an interfacing all across the back side of it to stiffen it. Now this is not the interfacing you'd actually put in this type fabric, because generally speaking you use lining or dress or blouse fabric for the lining, and it really shouldn't take this heavy an interfacing, except this is an exception. When you make a bag, you do interface it kind of heavily so it holds up, so it's really sturdy. Okay, I've interfaced all that, and then I have just folded it the way it needed to be. And the easiest way to do this, to get it just right, is to first fold it in half. And so after I had it folded in half, then I went ahead and pressed this fold. So that one down here needs pressing. And then I wanted this section to come down and up again, and I just wanted to make sure that it was shorter here inside than the upper section will be. So I folded this section like this. The other one is folded identically so that I have those two center folds and then the two outer labels or layers. Does it make sense so far? So I've got all of these, and then I have about a half inch folded over for the seam allowance, because the zipper will go in this outer part. Now what we're going to do is go over to the machine, and I'm going to put a zipper between these two folds for the intersections, And then I am going to put a zipper between the two outer folds. Then I'm going to stitch the ends, and then it's ready to put in a bag. So it really is quite simple and something that everybody can do. Okay, my two zippers here are longer again than the bag, which is quite all right, it doesn't matter. And I'm putting these in with a contrasting thread so that you can see what it looks like. And this is a little bit of an awkward place to stitch because I'm going to be between these two inner layers. But realize that nothing is attached down at the bottom, so it can kind of open up, and that makes it easier. Now with this longer zipper, it doesn't matter a bit which end you cut off. I think it's probably easier in this case to use this end. Keep the tab out of the way when I sew the zipper in. And except I'm going to, for the second side, have to open the zipper to make it easier. But anyway, it's just going to be putting it up close. Now, a zipper foot is probably going to be easier for you, so I'll quickly just change to one. And when I do the outer bag, when I put the lining in the with its zipper and the outer bag together, I might find that I can't do it with this zipper foot. You might even find that you need to use a Teflon foot if you're using one of the man-made leathers or suedes in order for it not to get hung up on the machine so it will move freely. So think about it, try it out on a scrap to see what you're going to have to use. And I'm thinking, okay, which side do I want the foot on? The needle is going to go down in the center. The zipper is going to be on the other side, apart from the foot. So now they're just right, and I'm all ready to do this. And it really doesn't need to be pinned, and it's going to fall open, and that's okay, it won't matter. This is nice crisp fabric, and especially with the interfacing, so it's very easy to hold in place. So I'll just do this. I'm going to do big stitches. I wanted you to see what was happening, so I have a contrasting thread. I'll do really big stitches so it just pulls out and I can put the actual color thread that I want in it for the bag later. Okay, you can see this is going to be an exposed zipper. So I'm just putting the fold of the fabric and put the needle down position to make it easier. I'm just putting the fold of the fabric right up to the edge of the zipper coil. And once I get this side stitched, then the other side can be done. These are real big stitches, like 4.5 or 5 or maybe even bigger. I could make them in order to pull it out easily later on. And once this one is all stitched, then we'll do the other one. And be ready to go with the second zipper. So I've never timed myself on this, but really you could make several in one day. This is kind of a nice way to use up things that you have in your stash. Now I'm trying to think how is going to be the easiest way to do this. I'll be in trouble if I try to do it this way because I don't have a big enough opening here to get to the other end. So here it's going to be sensible to start at the open end where I can unzip this zipper. And once I have that unzipped, before I unzip it, I better put a pin to make sure that they're in the right position so that the edge of this part of the lining comes up to the edge of this part of the lining. So I will pin it, and then I'll unzip it, and everything will be just exactly in the right position, and I can open up the zipper and do an easy job of it. There's always some easy way to do it if you just think it through, so don't be too hasty when you're doing this. Going to unzip it, and then when it opens up, you can see, no problem at all. I don't even have to change the position of the zipper foot because I'm stitching the opposite direction, so it's still on the proper side. Okay. Pull that pin out and keep going. Well, what I started to say is that these are so easy to make, and they really are such fun, and any kind of fabric will go into them. It doesn't matter what you use. Think about these for gift items, for holiday giving, for bazaar items, because you can produce a lot of these in a short period of time. Any of the big bags take a half yard of fabric. Any of the small bags take only a quarter yard. So it just doesn't take much. And from almost every project you make, from dresses or blouses, you have extra fabric, enough little extra that you can use for linings. And it is also legal to go to your local store and see what they have available. Okay, I'm going to have to zip. No, I'm not. I can go past. Yes, I am going to have to zip up just a little bit of this to get it past the foot. So, okay, I've come to an area where it's going to be a little. No, I'm not going to have to. I can get away from it here. But every once in a while, you might come to a difficult area just for a few inches that you have to deal with, but this one wasn't really too bad. Okay, once we get this out of here and cut off those threads short, then we have the inner part all done. And so you can see, here's the inner compartment, and at this time I really could cut off the edge of the zipper, but don't cut it off while you have the tab down here. Make sure that if you're going to cut that zipper off, you have the tab somewhere in the bag area, and I'm not going to cut it off until I sew the end. So one zipper is done. The other zipper then is going to come at the outside, and whether they both zip the same direction, it's up to you. If you think that you need a system and they both go the same way, I don't know that they do, but I'll just put this one the other way. Now think through how this top zipper needs to be. Remember I said at the outset that we wanted this tab to be on the outside, on the interfacing side, because it's going to slip inside the bag. I'm going to cover it with the leather or come up to here with the leather. So this is the position in which I want this to be. So I'm going to start it up here and just put a pin to hold it in place. And what the inside of the bag will look like then is very nicely finished. You can see the tape's out of the way. It's on the outside of the bag, but then the outer bag covers that tape, so it's okay. It's going to look just fine. So this one needs to be here. The other one needs to be over here, so I better pin it in place too so I won't lose my place. And this one I'm doing the opposite way for really no good reason. It simply doesn't matter that much which way you do it. Whatever seems convenient to you. So the other one I was doing with the tab end free and using the lower end of the zipper in the bag. This time I'm going to cut that end off, and it really just doesn't matter. Okay, to do this stitching now, you can see the whole thing will fall open. Therefore, it isn't a problem to get it in the machine and under the foot. Now remember, if your machine has the capability, you can always change the needle position, and this might make it easier to get around the tab. Now this second zipper looks kind of funny in that the tab's down, and you really never stitch a zipper this way, do you? But it's going to be down in this case because, remember, we want the inside of the bag, which is what this is, the inside of the purse, everything looks neat. The outside has the tape there, which looks funny, but the outer bag will cover it. So here we have it in place, and it's ready to go. And okay, needle down position, hold it in place so everything is easy to adjust. Then we'll go ahead and get past that tab. And from then on, it's just smooth sailing the rest of the length of the zipper. To have this nice crisp fabric that has been pressed really flat and to have all that interfacing inside makes this an easier job than it usually is on clothing, which is not as crisp as this. Crisp is easy. It's soft and drapey fabrics that always give you the most problems. Okay, we're through with this one, and now we're ready for the other side, and then we can do the ends of the bag. And let me get this around and figure out exactly how we want to do the second side. Okay, the second side, I want to unzip the zipper for probably, but before I unzip it again, I want to get this fabric placed just right so that it lines up with the first side that was put down. So I'll put a pin in there, and then we can do the second side the very same way. Pin out. Some people prefer, by the way, to use glue stick in places like this. I'm a pinner instead of a gluer. So whatever is easy for you, it has no hard and fast rules. Just do it as you please. Now there are a lot of other fastener ideas also that you might use. You don't need to put zippers in this outside. You might have a flap coming over the top, for instance, and use pretty buttons, or use some of the commercial hardware that you can find in shops, the magnets and so on, that will do the job. You don't have to have a zipper. A zipper just seems easy, and so that's why I'm doing it. Okay, we're all finished with this. In a couple more stitches, and then we're ready to just sew the ends. And now we're ready to get this all, it looks like a jumble. Now we're ready to kind of figure out exactly what we have and get it going. And so I'm going to stand up here to shake it out and get it in the right position. Okay, here's how it's going to be inside the bag. And this will, I better get these zippers inside so they don't end up getting cut off. Okay, I wanted to have both those tabs inside. Now, for the last part of putting this together is just shaking it out. We have all the lower edges here together, three lower edges. And they don't need to be joined in any way. They're just going to hang down in the bottom of the purse and they're fine. All we need to do is stitch across both ends and across the zipper tapes. And the nice thing about these coil zippers is the fact that you can stitch right across them and no harm done. They're polyester rather than metal. Okay, I'm going to probably, as I stitch, just fold this zipper in half. And notice how the inside section is shorter down here, about an inch shorter, but also I want it to be a little narrower. I found when I made this first bag, it all works better if that center section is a little narrower. So as I sew up the ends, I found it's a good idea to take that center section and just pull it out about a half inch or so, so that it extends beyond the outer layers, about a half inch as you can see here, and I'll just taper to nothing at the bottom, but at the top edge it will be a little narrower. Now it looks funny when it's flat, but it works out just right when it's inside your bag, and I think the reason that it works out right is because the outer bag holds this taut, and yet the inside just sort of folds around if you have it too long and is in your way. So this works well. So we'll do that on each end. I'll just sit down here and sew up this end. And for this, from now on, it doesn't matter if you have a zipper foot or what you have, it's all going to work just fine. And it is working so hard, it is really heavy there because I have, well, let's see, two, because it's interfaced, so I have two layers, four, six, eight, 10, 12 layers of fabric is what I have here. So that's what makes it so heavy. And when I get right up to the top, I'm going to fold that zipper in half so that I can stitch over it. And we finish up and cut off the threads, and we're through with that side. And then there's just the second side to do. And so you can see how the second side just falls right into place. That's going to be real easy to do. And again, before I would sew that, I would pull it out that half inch so that it pulls the middle tighter, and it only looks funny for a little while. Once it's in the bag, it'll be just great. So go ahead and sew that, cut off the ends of the zippers after you make sure the tabs are here in the midsection so that you don't cut away the pulls, the tabs. And then we're going to put that inside the bag, and once it's inside here, everything falls in place just beautifully. And then to stitch it together, I'll just unzip the zipper the rest of the way. I'll fold this edge under and put it up here close to the zipper coil and just top stitch around there. So it's really a very simple thing. Now sometimes it looks pretty to pipe the top edge, which I did on this last bag, the painted one. So a little piping there is fine. In that case, you stitch in the ditch and it never shows. Think also, once you have this in, if you're having zippers, what kind of pulls you might put on them. There are a lot of commercial ones that you can buy. What I'm going to put on these, I have on a little leather thong here, these heavy carved bones or whatever it is, I'm not sure, but they're going to make nice pulls on that zipper. Sometimes I might put tassels on, as I have on this one, and that makes a nice little pull for the zipper. So do something to make it look more commercial, to make it look like it's not loving hands at home, and you're going to come up with something very ingenious, I'm sure. Send me some pictures of some of those pretty things you do. I love to see them. I get a lot of them in the mail, and I always appreciate seeing what people have done to expand on some of the ideas that I have put out on a show. So anytime you have something like that, let me know about it. Now, after we have these all done, then we're going to have to think about something else. A tiny little purse like this, for instance. It doesn't need compartments, as it's not going to hold much anyway. But how can you get these little wrinkles in suede or in any fabric? Join me next time for a new wrinkle, and we'll look into it.